South Africa has no money. We are running record levels of debt as a country. We have, through corruption and the last 12 years of complete corruption, major state-owned enterprises. So the electricity generators, the logistics, transportation companies, weapons manufacturers, you know, which used to be kind of beacons of success, the national airlines, South African Airways, were completely destroyed through corruption. So they owe a lot of money. So we entered the lockdown bankrupt as a country, and the situation has only worsened. The government in South Africa, the interesting thing is, you know, the current ANC, or in fact, the cabinet that is running the country right now, were all trained in East Germany. So we've got a very nice communist approach to the manner in which the situation is being handled in South Africa. So completely totalitarian, undemocratic. They trampled over, you know, our constitutional rights. But the reality is that what they don't want to do is they cannot do is borrow money from IMF and from the World Bank. So IMF has been to South Africa marketing themselves as you know, potential savers. The problem with IMF bailouts is that you immediately have to implement reforms. And number one reform is reduce the size of your public service. So let go of people. Two, cut salaries, cut pension benefits, cut social aid. And ANC, which runs African National Congress, which runs South Africa, cannot allow that to happen. So they are caught in a vice of not being able to borrow from IMF and World Bank, and as a consequence, actually not having any money to sustain a recovery or to sustain the economy as is.